An unprecedented look at how Islamic State militants have spread across one country at the center of the war on terrorism. With remarkable access to the militants themselves, tonight's report, ISIS in Afghanistan, shows how the group is expanding its control in the country, fighting some members of the Taliban, co-opting others, and battling Afghan National Army forces. William Brangham has the story.
After months of negotiations, Afghan journalist Najibullah Quraishi got permission from ISIS militants to come visit their stronghold in Afghanistan. In his frontline report, Quraishi shows not only how ISIS is gaining power in that nation, but also how they're indoctrinating young Afghan children into their cause.
In the ISIS-held district of Shigal, the group is using many techniques to groom young children to fight and die for the Islamic State. The fighters tell Najibullah they receive propaganda videos directly from ISIS in Syria and Iraq. They say they show the videos to the village children every day.
I was asking them why they're watching in front of these young children. They said they should learn, they should know from now, and it's normal for them.
The videos don't just show attacks and atrocities. This is an ISIS military school for children somewhere in the Middle East.
These videos, they're just telling them how to kill people, how to behave, and how to become suicide bombers. And their main thing is to kill infants. This is their aim. And they clearly telling this is in Quran. So what the child believe? What he think? He think, yes, I'm Muslim, and he's telling me the truth.
Najibullah films the Afghan children copying what they've just watched.
When I saw these young children, I was really, really upset, really sad. I was thinking about Afghanistan's future, Afghanistan's next generation. What we have next? These children who learn how to kill people, how to do jihad, how to behave, how to fire, this would be Afghanistan. I was thinking maybe the war will never end, never. And the people will keep suffering from war.
Najibullah Quraishi joins me now from London. Welcome. This is a very, very powerful piece of reporting. You really get to see ISIS in action in a way that many of us in the West have never seen before. Why is it, do you think, they let you in?
When I heard first about ISIS in Afghanistan, I started contacting the people who used to work for me, I mean some local journalists. And then we found some villagers and elders. So through the elders, we sent a message out to them, to their leader, I mean ISIS commander in Afghanistan. I asked them if they allow me to film them about their present in Afghanistan. So then they told to the villagers or the people I sent over to wait. So I was waiting for almost over eight months until they called us in and they said, come and we are ready to be filmed. So I was excited that I'm going to meet them or filming them about their daily life, or at least I would expose them what they are doing there. And the other side of my life was there, my family, my wife, my children. To be honest, this was kind of 50-50. I was like 50% hope that I would come back again, and 50% I wasn't. To expose such kind of stories, it's always dangerous. It's always, there is a risk. But we have to tell the story. If not, then who should tell?
The scenes of the children and the education, if you can call it that, that they're getting are really quite terrifying. And I wonder if you could just tell us a little bit more about the men who think that this is a good thing to teach children so young to learn how to kill.
I never seen this in my journalism life before. At the beginning, I didn't know when they mentioned me, they have a school, they have a children, if I want to go and film. I was thinking maybe there's a proper lesson. They maybe learn some mathematics, some grammar or some language or something, or maybe in proper Quran, I was thinking like this. But suddenly I come across with jihad for 3 years old or 4 years, 5 years old children. You're telling what is jihad and how to kill. So then I was shocked.
Jihad. Jihad.
These guys mainly came from Pakistan. They were telling me this is the time they should teach the children. And they should learn from now and they should be prepared. For them, they should be ready for fighting for everything at the age of 12 or 13 or something like this. They were asking the children about the weapons. For example, where it's made, how many bullets it takes, where this pistol made from, where is Kalashnikov made from, why we should use this, and who should we against with this, and why. So lots of different things which the children knew from this age. Then on the film you can see the second generation, which is older or teenagers, like 13 or 17, and they're ready to blow themselves up or to do a suicide attack. I came in a conclusion about Afghanistan's future and Afghanistan's next generation. Still we have over 90% uneducated people. We don't have security. Day by day, all the terrorists coming to Afghanistan, all the foreigners. Right now in Afghanistan, we have Akani network, we have Hizb Islami or Ikmatyar, and we have the Taliban. And now we have this crazy group, the most worst group ever I seen in my life. And I cannot see any bright future about that country. And I don't think if there is any power to defeat them.
Given the news of the most recent attacks that we've seen in France just recently, everyone has been wondering about ISIS's motives. And you've actually now spent a good deal of time with some of these militants. When you heard about the attacks in France, did that come as a surprise to you or not?
Well, to be honest, no, it doesn't come as a surprise for me, because their aim is not, they are not talking about one village or one district or one country. They are talking about the world. They're not like a Taliban. For example, the Taliban says, we are in Afghanistan and we are not threat for other countries or Russia or Iran or other countries. Our aim is to capture Afghanistan and to have Sharia law here in Afghanistan. But they are not like this. They says, we want to go to Europe. We want to go to like other countries like Uzbekistan, Tajikistan, China, Iran, Pakistan. And they are threatening the world. They are not threatening only one country or one province or one district.
Najibullah Quraishi, thank you very much for joining us, and thank you for this terrific piece of journalism.
You're welcome. Thanks a lot. Frontline.